G'day guys, it's Trav here from Neighbourhood. Today we're going to get stuck into how to add buyer personas inside your HubSpot account. HubSpot does rattle on a lot about buyer personas, but how do I contextually use them inside HubSpot? Well, today I'm going to show you exactly how to do that and utilize the tool so that you can attach buyer personas to certain people inside your HubSpot system. If you haven't got time to watch this video, we do have a step-by-step PDF inside the description below. All you have to do is click on it and download it, and it's free to use. Without further ado, let's get stuck into creating buyer personas inside HubSpot. So for this, you can have any sort of subscription to HubSpot, a free account, a pro account, or an enterprise, it just doesn't matter. So in order to get kicked off, all you have to do is when you land inside HubSpot, go up to the cog and click on the cog. So now that we're in the cog, we're gonna go down the left-hand side and click on the properties tab. This is where the buyer persona properties live, and you'll be able to attach them to the contacts. So you'll notice here that you've got a whole bunch of different properties that you might have created. If you're new to HubSpot, it would be one straight out of the box. This is under contact properties. So it comes standard with every single HubSpot account. So what we want to do is we want to go up to the search area and we want to type in persona. It used to be called buyer personas. And then what we do is we click on the persona area here, and it will bring a drop down from the right hand side. This has changed a little bit over the years, but then this will look a little bit different from the other type of properties that we've got there. So what we do, it should come empty if this is new to you, and click on persona. And this looks a little bit different from the other personas if you've played in this tool a little bit before. Best practice states that you've got to go through and fill this out into its entirety, and also be really descriptive. Now this video isn't really necessarily around buyer personas, so I'm not going to go into detail about what you should and shouldn't be doing. There is some information at the very top there about accessing the Make My Persona tool app on HubSpot, and also learning the basics on HubSpot, personas as well in HubSpot. So what we'll go through there is we can fill out all of these details that we've got here, and we can basically go and create, Mary, the marketing manager. Whoops. Mary, the marketing manager, and I can fill out all of these details as we go through. I'm going to fill out a description. Now you've got to fill out all the details here. Obviously, in the spirit of getting this video done and dusted as quick as we can, I'm going to click on save, and then it should pop up there with Mary, the marketing manager, and click on save. Now, the great thing about that now is that it will now be available as a property. For example, if you go up to contacts and we select the first contact that we've got, let's just say, what have we got here? Let's go Jody Berry. And we go up to Jody, and then we go down the left-hand side here. We haven't got the personas here, but if I can view all of the properties here, and I go and type in persona, I can sit there and I can add that to my view, and I'll go back. It's a little cheeky one on how to add properties to your contact card. It's a little extra one there for you. It will now give us the opportunity to see our personas, and then we can click on that, and we've got the dummy text that we've got there. Click on that, and then we can click on save. The great thing about that is that we can start to use that in dynamic smart lists if we need to, or static lists if we want to. You can use workflows if you have got Marketing Pro and above to be able to dynamically add the persona to the person when that person goes through on a contact form. Keep in mind that we personally use that for here at Neighbourhood to understand what type of people are coming into our business. And then we're able to report that at the end of every single year as well. And there you have it. All you need to know about adding personas inside HubSpot. If you're keen to really make the most out of your HubSpot investment, Neighbourhood offers a step-by-step course covering marketing, sales, service, CMS, and operations hub in depth, ensuring you and your team are best serving your customers while offering efficient internal processes. We'll include a link for this in the description below. As well as, if you've gained value for this video and keen to learn more about HubSpot, make sure you hit that subscribe button. And don't forget that PDF is in the description below if you need that step-by-step. Anyway, that's it for me, and happy HubSpotting.